The ongoing water dispute between Telangana and Andhra Pradesh has flared up once again. Though we haven't seen both the chief ministers directly attack each other, both the states have shot off letters and made some provocative statements. Why did this issue flare up now? What are the consequences of it? We break it down for you. Water issues between the two states date back to even before the formation of Telangana. To understand the history of the dispute, it is important to understand the geography of the river. The Krishna River, which originates in the Western Ghats, flows through Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh before it finally reaches the Bay of Bengal. Jorala, Sri Sailam, Nagarjuna Sagar and Pulichintala are the dams that are located on the Krishna River. Andhra Pradesh is located on the right side of the Sri Sailam, Nagarjuna Sagar and Pulichintala dams, while Telangana is on the other side. The latest disagreement is over one project, the Rayalaseema Lift Irrigation Project. While Telangana calls it illegal, Andhra Pradesh says it is a necessity. Telangana says that the Rayalaseema Lift Irrigation Project is an illegal project which does not have the required clearances from the Central Water Commission. It also maintains that the project has not been accorded the environmental clearances, the same reason for which the state's Sitarama Lift Irrigation Project was deferred. In a letter to the Union Government, Telangana has contended that through this project, Andhra Pradesh plans to divert a substantial amount of Krishna River water outside the basin and that this can affect the ecosystem of the region. The letter also mentions how several wildlife sanctuaries that are located within the 10-kilometer radius of the canal will be affected by the project. Thus, Telangana has taken up the environmental route, hoping to put spokes in the wheels of the Andhra project. Telangana has been claiming that Andhra Pradesh has already been drawing excess water from River Krishna. However, Andhra Pradesh has clearly maintained that their new project will only be diverting water that has already been allotted to the state. Andhra Pradesh has also questioned Telangana generating power from the Sri Sailam, Nagarjuna and the Pulichintala water reservoir from June 1st, which is the beginning of the water year. Andhra Pradesh says that when Telangana does this, they are forced to go ahead with the Rayalaseema Lift Irrigation Project.
ఎక్కడా కూడా మాకు అలొకేషన్ చేసిన వాటర్ లోంచి తీసుకొని కట్టుకుంటాం అని చెప్పి ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారు గాని స్పష్టంగా కేటగారికల్ గా చెప్తున్నాం. రోజు ఉదాహరణకి అక్కడ చూసుకున్నప్పుడైతే వాళ్ళు కడుతున్నాయి చూస్తా ఉంటే ఎటువంటి పర్మిషన్స్ లేవు, అక్రమంగా వాళ్ళు కడుతున్నారు, కానీ ఎక్కడా కూడా ఈ రాష్ట్ర ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారు ఇదిగా ఉన్నారు.
రియాక్టింగ్ టు ఆంధ్రాస్ క్లెయిమ్ దట్ ఓన్లీ ది ఎక్సెస్ వాటర్ విల్ బి యూజ్డ్ బై ఆంధ్రా, తెలంగాణ మినిస్టర్ శ్రీనివాస్ గౌడ్ అలెజ్డ్ దట్ ఆంధ్రా వాస్ లైయింగ్.
వాళ్ళు చెప్తున్న దానిలో మిగులు జలాల దానిలో పచ్చి అవధాలు వాస్తవం లేని లేదన్న 100%. మిగులు జలాలు ఎప్పుడవుతాయి? శ్రీశైలం మొత్తం నిండాలి, నాగార్జున సాగర్ నిండాలి, పులిచింతలు నిండాలి. నిండి అలుగు దుంకి సముద్రంలో కలుస్తున్నప్పుడు అప్పుడు ఇక్కడ నీళ్లు స్టార్ట్ చేసుకోవాలి. అప్పుడు అన్ని రిజర్వాయర్లు నిండిన తర్వాత మిగిలేటివే మిగులు జలాలు. అవి నిండక ముందే దారిలో పోతుపోతే పోత దారిలోనే నువ్వు పంపులేసి వచ్చిన లాగి పడేస్తే అవి మిగులు జలాలు ఎట్లయితేనే అడుతా ఉన్నాను.
Confused with the claims of both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana? Wait, let me break it down for you. To understand this issue, it is important to understand the AP Reorganization Act of 2014. According to the Act's water sharing agreement, drinking water is first priority, then comes irrigation and finally power generation. Andhra says, when our people are deprived of water, why use it for power generation? This is, however, not the only issue. Out of the 811 TMC feet of water, the AP Reorganization Act allocated 299 TMC feet to Telangana and 512 TMC feet to Andhra Pradesh. Though it was initially agreed upon, Telangana later flagged that a lion's share of the water was being given to Andhra Pradesh. Telangana demanded that a reallocation of the water needs to be done, as Telangana was a new state. Telangana recently demanded that water should be shared on a 50-50% basis and that a new tribunal should be set up to look into the water sharing policy between Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So what has stoked this entire controversy? The Srisalam Dam's left bank lies in Telangana, whereas the right bank lies in Andhra Pradesh. The Pothireddupad head regulator lies in the Srisalam reservoir. A head regulator allows water to enter into a canal. The Pothireddupad head regulator is what takes water to the Rayalaseema region of Andhra Pradesh. While the full tank limit of the dam is 885 feet, the Pothireddupad head regulator is located at 848 feet. A maximum of 44,000 cusecs of water can enter into the Pothireddupad head regulator. However, now the Andhra Pradesh government plans to widen the header to allow 88,000 cusecs of water as part of their new project. When the water year began in June, Telangana began to generate power from the dams. This means water was being let out from the dams only for the purpose of generating power. Andhra Pradesh is crying foul at Telangana's attempts to generate electricity, saying it is depriving drought-prone areas of Rayalaseema of water. Telangana says that Andhra Pradesh has no moral right to raise this issue, as the state plans to go ahead with its own project and also hopes to widen the gates of the head regulator. In fact, both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana have been saying that their projects were decided and conceived even before the state was bifurcated, and hence that they require no new permissions and clearances. Other than the war of words about water and dams, another point of contention between the two states is the Krishna River Management Board and its interventions.
The Krishna River Management Board has not yet given any allocations or award regarding the Krishna watershed between Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. But Andhra Pradesh, without any permissions for constructing Rayalaseema lift, the capacity of Pothireddupad head regulator and also RDS, they are continuing to construct, which is going to cause gross injustice to Telangana. And that is the reason Telangana has petitioned to the NGT, and also there was a pending petition with the Supreme Court, and NGT has clearly realized that Andhra Pradesh is constructing a Rayalaseema lift irrigation, claiming it to be just a drinking water project, but there is a component of irrigation also in it. And that is why NGT has asked Andhra Pradesh to facilitate a three-member committee since last 6 months, but Andhra Pradesh has been delaying this three-member committee to come and visit there. The government of Telangana demands the Krishna River Management Board to see that Andhra Pradesh stops the construction of Pothireddupad Rayalaseema lift and RDS.
According to the AP Reorganization Act of 2014, any dispute in sharing of water should be amicably resolved by the Krishna River Management Board. In case any state isn't convinced, they have the option of approaching the Apex Council for its final decision. Experts feel that both the Krishna River Management Board and the Apex Council have failed to diffuse the situation, and no concrete step has been taken up by them. Experts feel that Y. Sharmila's entry into the political fray in Telangana is only further going to politicize the entire issue of water sharing. In fact, at a recent public meeting, Y. Sharmila announced that her party would fight and support Telangana's fight for its rightful share of the water.
తెలంగాణకు అన్యాయం జరిగే ప్రాజెక్టును అడ్డుకుంటుందా అని మాట మీద నిలబడే రాజన్న బిడ్డగా చెప్తున్నాను. తెలంగాణకు దక్కాల్సిన ఒక్క చుక్క నీటి బొట్టును కూడా వదులుకో. తెలంగాణకు అన్యాయం జరిగే ఏ ప్రాజెక్టునైనా ఏ పనినైనా నేను అడ్డుకుంటా. తెలంగాణ ప్రజల కోసం నిలబడతా.
Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy has been writing to the Union Government, urging them to step in and rein in the Telangana government. Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao has declared that in every fora the state would be fighting to ensure that the people of Telangana get their rightful share of Krishna River. Now, all eyes are on the Union Government, on the Krishna River Management Board and the Apex Council to issue clear directions to ensure that this entire issue or controversy is resolved. This is Paul Lumen reporting for the News Minute.